You mentioned that Carl, of course, was the family photographer, and he sort of inherited that camera that your dad brought back from Germany, right? Mm-hmm.
He would lend it to Dad on occasion.
I was absolutely captured by the beautiful camera Dad brought home from Germany, and I was in it up to my ears. Hell, I took a lot of photographs, everything. And so, obviously, to be photographing what's going on at the shack was pretty easy to come by.
Carl Leopold was a well-known plant physiologist whose 1964 textbook, Plant Growth and Development, became a classic in the field. He was a prominent and eloquent spokesman for his father's land ethic philosophy, incorporating it into his own writings, lectures, and work through the Tropical Forestry Initiative and the Finger Lakes Land Trust in New York. Carl published some 200 scientific papers and 5 books on plant physiology. He too was widely honored for his work in science and conservation.
I feel that Carl often regretted that he was too young to go on all the camping trips with Dad.
That's an understatement.
The older brothers got to go. But I think with the instigation of the shack, Carl and Dad were best friends.
One time, driving home, I think, after a weekend at the shack, Dad and I were alone in the car, and I said, I was a freshman in college, and had signed up for some courses in botany. And I said, Dad, what do you think, what should I go into as a profession? And there was a long pause, and he said, well, he said, what would you like to do? There was no way he was gonna say, you should do this or you should do that. So he avoided that very carefully, but that didn't matter. I went into biology anyhow.
I started a graduate program at the University of Missouri. And this was interrupted in the first couple of months because of Pearl Harbor and the President Roosevelt's talk on Monday morning. All of us who were in graduate school, I dare say that everybody signed up for the military, everybody to different places. I was on Palmyra Island and the Christmas Island series. One day, I found curlews on the island. And so my next letter home, I said, there have been Eskimo curlews here. And Dad then knew exactly where I was. And I think he was really pleased with himself. He said, I know where Carl is.
My brother Carl became a plant physiologist, has worked in detailed work all his life, and he is now involved in restoring tropical rainforests in Costa Rica.
My wife and I have become very much involved, a type of parallel effort in Costa Rica. We've become very enchanted by Costa Rica. We see that the land has been enormously misused, the cutting down of the tropical rainforests and substituting pastures has been at a great cost. The land is just very fragile, and this has been a catastrophe. We provided money to buy some acreage of abandoned pastures, and we have been planting about 5,000 trees of up to 45 or 50 species a year. I dare say you can notice that there's something analogous to what happened at the shack.
A group of us in Ithaca have formed a green cemetery. This is a place where you bury bodies as they are. And it's very rewarding to see the kind of sensitivity that the people that are using the cemetery, how they feel about putting the body back to nature. And it's lovely.